Marion County taxpayers may soon be paying more for mass transit. A city county council committee agreed to send a multi-million dollar plan to the full council for a vote. Our City Beat reporter Mary Mills has more on what's at stake and what it could cost.
We shall overcome.
They sang before the meeting and they prayed that committee members would move the transit plan forward.
God, there is purpose in what we're doing right now, God.
We want every individual to be able to be productive, a productive citizen, and sometimes it may take this bus service for them to be able to do that.
At issue, whether to raise the county income tax by 0.025% or $100 for each $40,000 of taxable income. Doing so would raise $54 million a year for Indigo, money it would use to expand service with buses running farther out and more often. The tax would also help fund 3 rapid bus transit routes. Most here spoke in favor.
I use transit to get to my several doctor's appointments, to the dentist, to the pharmacy.
On our Route 24, we have no service past 7 p.m. and no Sunday service.
And being able to take the bus every 15 minutes instead of every 30 or 45 makes a huge difference.
But opponents weren't buying it.
The operation and management of Indigo over the years gives me no confidence that extra funding will bring many improvements, if any.
I'm not opposed to the transit tax. I am opposed to how the money's going to be spent.
Lee Lang told committee members she doesn't want any money going to the red line along College. She fears the impact on traffic and parking will hurt her business and others. Others spoke of the personal cost.
Here you are, going to force me to pay for something that I don't use, don't plan on using.
The committee voted 5-2 to pass the plan on to the full council. Monroe Gray, one of the no votes.
I don't think that the finances is in place that's going to make this work. And I think down the line, this is going to be worse than what happened with the first Justice Center.
His Democratic colleagues disagreed.
We can't continue to progress without a public transportation system that is robust, that gets people on a regular basis, on a predictable basis, across town.
The counselors I talked to do expect a close vote come Monday. They say if it fails, though, it could come back at a later date as a new proposal. John?
All right, thank you. Mary Mills reporting tonight. Now, if that proposal passes on Monday, the tax increase would take effect in October.